Sneha, similar protest sites and scenes in Kerala as well this morning?
That's right, this is the Indian Medical Association and the association doctors who have gathered outside the secretariat. The slogans are protect the doctors, keep the doctors safe. Let's listen to them, what really are their demands. So, your name, please?
Yeah, Dr. Sulfi, Secretary of the Indian Medical Association, Kerala State Branch.
Dr. Sulfi, you're very far away from Calcutta, where this incident happened.
Oh, yes, definitely Kerala. Kerala people, you know. The doctors and Kerala people will be responding to any kind of violence at any time. So, if this is, this cannot be accepted. A doctor, while doing his dirty duty in a hospital, was brutally attacked. It cannot be tolerated. And Ahmedabad must understand that it cannot be tolerated. And the doctors of, relaxed doctors of this country, will not allow this. And he will go for interference strike if it continues.
All right, Mr. Sulfi, let me ask you this. What are your demands here?
Yeah, the basic demand is that we need a central rule. We need a central rule which says that doctors are, and hospitals are exempted from attacks and violent mobs. We need protection. We need a central rule to prevent hospital violence.
All right, so let's also get a sense from people, other doctors here, ma'am. Are you on duty? Were you supposed to be on duty today?
Yeah, I am on duty. I'm a gynecologist also. I have to be in the hospital this time. But this is a very valid protest because we gynecologists are facing a lot of issues.
Like, I mean, can you explain?
Yeah, definitely. So it's, anything can happen to any patient at any time. So patients feel that they're perfectly normal, but they may not be. There may be so many issues with them. So they can face any problem at any point of time. But when we try to explain to them, they cannot understand it. And they will react in a different way. But reacting like this is too horrible.
Ma'am, your name?
Anupama.
So, Dr. Anupama, let me explain to us what was the trigger. Now, this has been happening for a long time. But what got all of you together across India?
Yeah, this is, so some amount of atrocities against doctors we were tolerating for a long time. But this is a brutal attack. This is a brutal attack against an young doctor. That's we cannot tolerate. So we have to work in a peaceful atmosphere. Our mind, our body and everything has to be peaceful. Then only we can work properly. We can help people. We can treat people. So that is our demand. We have to work properly.
Let me get some young doctors here. Your name, please?
Ajita.
So, Dr. Ajita, you're a young doctor. How many years experience?
I have just finished my internship. And I'm so sorry that an intern like me has faced this. This is such brutality. And any human being needs a safety work atmosphere. And without safety, how can we save others' lives? We need to save our lives first. We are also human beings. We are not doctors. We cannot prevent death. We can only delay death. But also the response from Mamata Banerjee is too bad. They are treating the doctors like terrorists. They are, she has been demanding to get the hostels if they were not stopping the protest. And this is too bad.
Okay. Sir, your name, please?
Dr.
Srijit and Kumar. So, Dr. Srijit, what are your needs? You know, you're very far away from Kolkata. Across India, these protests are happening. As doctors, you know, you have several women and male doctors here. What are your demands?
No, this is a basic thing which we require. Basically, we need to ensure patient safety and treatment quality. There has to be peace in hospitals. The doctors, junior doctors, interns should be allowed to practice peacefully so that we can deliver proper care for the patients. So that is why we are requesting for a central act against violence. Now, we can't tolerate violence in the hospitals. So this is a very peaceful token protest which is happening throughout the country to ensure that there is such an act in place and to ensure that there is peace in hospitals.
So, doctor, tell me something. Are you going to go back to work today or are you going to continue in this protest?
Definitely, we have to go back to work. Patients are waiting for us. Definitely, we have to work.
And is this going to continue for a few more days or is it just today as a token thing for us?
No, the national leadership, yesterday they were in Kolkata. Today they are in meeting in Delhi and we are looking at the response. The Chief Minister was unrelenting yesterday. But we are also approaching the national government, union government, as well as the state authorities. And if they continue their stubborn attitude, then the national leadership is seriously considering and all India shut down.
Okay, and let me ask you, is this about that one doctor in Kolkata? Or is it about doctors like you who are very far away from Kolkata?
Yes, in local places, this is always happening. It's a case of our survival. In future, this also happens to us. We are afraid of this. it's our right to treat patients, and we take it very carefully.
Okay. One last question, if I may. Ma'am, are you looking at certain protocols in your own hospitals to be more strictly implemented or to be put in place?
So there are protocols in all hospitals. Most of the multi-specialty hospitals, their critical care unit, their trauma rescue initiative units are maintaining protocols. They are maintaining standard protocols. So probably they might be treating the patient according to the protocols only. But this is not nothing related to the protocols.
No, protocol as in for safety for the doctors.
Yeah, definitely. Safety for the doctors, we have to, first, government has to ensure us something. So some strict laws has to come.
All right. Okay. Well, here you've heard from doctors, women and men who have taken out time from their very busy schedules and saying, listen, it's not just about one doctor, but it is about the need for a safe working environment for doctors across India.